So I'm currently at the book of Esther. So I want to talk about Queen Vashti. Now, what happened with Queen Vashti in the book of Esther, right? I guess, you know, does not really go well with the way the world runs today as far as Western society, Western culture. Yeah, you know, because it's very simple what happened with Queen Vashti. Very, very simple. But, you know, preachers nowadays, churches nowadays, they spin it. You know, they make it seem as if, you know, something else happened. And what it came down to, you know, the simple fact is that Queen Vashti disobeyed two things. Disobeyed, you know, the king, which I guess you could say, first of all, disobeyed the king, and then secondly, she disobeyed her husband. Right. So, imagine now you're a preacher in the pulpit in 2019, and you're telling in your church, you know, which oftentimes in churches is majority women, right? That would be a hard sermon to preach, isn't it? And then nowadays, you know, they don't really preach the whole Bible anyway. They don't, they don't say exactly what the Bible says, because the Bible is anti-cultural, you know. It's always, you know, well, Jesus Christ was anti-cultural. Okay, culture is going one way, society is going one way, and Christ is going the other way. The Bible has, you know, well, with Israel in the Old Testament, you know, it is what it, you know, it was what it was. I mean, you know, God picked out Israel and gave them laws, so, you know, you can't say that, the whole Bible is anti-cultural, because, you know, what you could say is that people have a natural tendency to go against God's word. Yeah, you could say that, you know, with Israel, because in the Old Testament it's just, you know, God contending with Israel. He picked up people out, gave them his laws, and it's him dealing with them, not the whole world, you know. But then again, the Israelites are human beings, so, you know, them, you know, they easily went against God's word anyway. So humanity, I guess, is, you know, is going one way, and God is going the other way. And these churches nowadays, you know, they don't want to rock the boat, you know, they want to, you know, line up with the culture. That's why they don't preach the whole Bible, and that's where they spin the story of Queen Vashti and Esther, because to make society, you know, not to ruffle the feathers, to make it, you know, seem, you know, to make it line up with, you know, modern culture, in which is what? Modern culture is women, you know, making women equal with men in all aspects. You know, a man is equal to a woman, you know, that's what society says in everything, right? So how are you going to have a woman disobeying her husband? Nah, can't have that. We got to spin this, you know? So how they spin it? So let's read the story of, real briefly, you know, I'm not going to read the whole thing. The pertinent parts, right? So King Ahasuerus, he threw a banquet, you know, for all his, just showing off, you know, showing all the power of Media and Persia, you know, through this huge party. And Queen Vashti was in charge of hosting the women, so she threw a party for the women also. So let me read from, let's read the whole chapter 1. Now it came to pass in the days of Ahasuerus, that this is Ahasuerus which reigned from India even unto Ethiopia, over 127 provinces, that in those days when the king Ahasuerus sat on the throne of his kingdom, which was in Shushan the palace, in the third year of his reign, he made a feast unto all his princes and his servants, the power of Persia and Media, the nobles and the princes of the provinces, being before him. When he shewed the riches of his glorious kingdom and the honor of his excellent majesty many days, even 104 days. And when these days were expired, the king made a feast unto all the people that were present in Shushan the palace, both unto great and small, 7 days in the court of the garden of the king's palace, where were white, green, and blue hangings fastened with cords of fine linen and purple of silver, rings and pillars of marble, and beds were of gold and silver upon a pavement of red and blue and white and black marble. So this is a fancy feast, just showing off the power of Media and Persia. You know, you can host a party for 180 days, I mean, in a year. That's a lot of money, you know, a lot of prestige, and he's the host. Verse 7. And they gave them drinking vessels of gold, the vessels being diverse from one another, and royal wine in abundance according to the state of the king. And the drinking was according to the law. None did compel, for so the king had appointed to all the officers of his house, that they should do according to every man's pleasure. Also Vashti the queen made a feast for the women in the royal house, which belonged to King Ahasuerus. I've heard people say that Vashti should not have done this, and that, I mean, she should have been at the king's feast. Bible doesn't say that. It says King Ahasuerus held a feast and Vashti held a feast. That's all it says. No spinning, no adding to it, no nothing. That's just what it says. And verse 10. On the seventh day, when the heart of the king was merry with wine, he commanded Mehuman, Bizda, Harbona, Bigda, and Abatha, Zethar, and Carcas, the seven chamberlains that served in the presence of Ahasuerus the king, to bring Vashti the queen before the king with the crown royal, to shew the people and the princes her beauty, for she was fair to look on. But the queen Vashti refused to come at the king's commandment by his chamberlains. Therefore was the king very wroth, and his anger burned in him. Then the king said to the wise men, which knew the times, for so was the king's manner towards all that knew law and judgment. And the next unto him was Karshina, Shethar, Admatha, Tarshish, Meres, Mersana, and Memican, the seven princes of Persia and Media, which saw the king's face, and which sat the first in the kingdom. What shall we do unto the queen Vashti according to the law, because she hath not performed the commandment of King Ahasuerus by the chamberlains? So, what the church normally says, or the preachers normally say, is that here the king was drunk. He was drunk, and everybody was drunk. 7 days after 7 days, you know, of drinking. Actually, it says 180 days, but okay, 7 days of drinking. The king was very drunk, and now he's drunk, he's in a drunken stupor, and he wants to call in his queen Vashti, who of course must have been, you know, probably the most beautiful woman in all Media and Persia, because, you know, the king get what he wants. I'm gonna have a hot lady, right? So he wants to show her off. So, and he said to, you know, Go and get Vashti and bring her, come on, you know, make sure she has on the royal crown, and, you know, and she said no. How this business is, they said, okay, he was drunk, he wanted her to come with just the crown on her head. That's what they said. So he wants her to come and stand before them naked with just the crown on her head, because he's drunk. Again, the Bible does not say that, okay? It doesn't say she should come naked. It says she should come with the crown royal. It doesn't mean that she's going to be naked. But if you want to make the king out to be a bad guy, you would say something that's stupid, that, okay, the king wants her to come naked and just with her crown. Didn't say that, because that would go well with a guy being drunk. I don't think that, you know, the king, well, it doesn't say that, okay? He just wanted to show off, you know, his beautiful wife / queen. So reading on. So now he's asking the wise men, what should we do? Because King, you know, Vashti disobeyed, the Queen Vashti disobeyed the king's order, number one. All right? The wise men answer in verse 16. Now, you know, when in church, you know, they don't touch verse 16. I mean, that's they make fun of King Ahasuerus, make light of the whole situation. He's drunk. Queen Vashti is disobeying because she doesn't want to come and parade herself naked, but, you know, in front of drunken men, you know, just a crown. And that's it. Then they go off and they start to preach about Vashti's, you know, a great woman and virtuous, you know, which makes no sense. Anyway, let's read this. This is what the wise men said. This is why you don't hear in church. And Memican answered before the king and the princes, Vashti the queen hath not done wrong to the king only, but also to all the princes and to all the people that are in all the provinces of the king Ahasuerus. For this deed of the queen shall come abroad unto all women, so that they shall despise their husbands in their eyes, when it shall be reported. The king Ahasuerus commanded Vashti the queen to be brought in before him, but she came not. Likewise shall the ladies of Persia and Media say this day unto all the king's princes, which have heard of the deed of the queen. Thus shall there arise too much contempt and wrath. If it please the king, let there go a royal commandment from him, and let it be written among the laws of the Persians and the Medes, that it be not altered, that Vashti come no more before King Ahasuerus, and let the king give her royal estate unto another that is better than she. And when the king's decree which he shall make shall be published throughout all his empire, for it is great, all the wives shall give to their husbands honor, both to great and small. And the saying pleased the king, and the princes and the king did according to the word of Memucan. For he sent letters into all the king's provinces, into every province according to the writing thereof, and to every people after their language, that every man should bear rule in his own house, and that it should be published according to the language of every people. Yeah. Imagine reading that in 2019 in a church with mostly women. Yeah, that's why I don't hear it. Okay? So, here's what makes no sense. If Vashti was a, as they say, a virtuous woman, you know, as I've seen that title, they say, I was looking up some sermons on Queen Vashti. Vashti, a virtuous woman. Yet still, they're saying here, you know, give her office to somebody who's better than she. Right? Better than she. Right? That's what the Bible says. That's what they said. And they said, you know, when women hear about this, what she did, it's going to be a bad thing. You're going to despise your husband. It's going to cause contempt and wrath. Again, how does that line up with her being a virtuous woman? Right? And the king sent letters throughout all his province. Right? Throughout the whole Media and Persia, saying that, you know what I'm saying, a man should bear rule in his own house. Okay? That every man should bear rule in his own house. Right? So, in conclusion, the Bible is saying, or it is reported that Queen, what she did would cause women to disrespect their husbands. Right? Because, you know, what she did was not virtuous, in other words. It wasn't a virtuous thing. It wasn't a good thing what she did. And also, if that's the case, right? They, Queen Esther, right? If what they're saying is true, that, Vashti did something good, a virtuous woman, right? And she, basically, she was, you know, this is an injustice for Vashti to be expelled from her office. It's an injustice. Then why is it that Esther, what would Esther do, Queen Esther do? Because she takes her office. So when Queen Esther is called to the king, naked and in a crown, she's gonna go, right? Right? Makes sense, right? Because if Vashti was wronged, she was expelled for no reason, then Queen Esther has no virtue. Queen Esther, is a sketel. You know? That's Jamaican for a loose woman. Yeah, she's nothing. She has no shame, no honor, because the queen is gonna, no doubt the king's gonna get up, you know, hold a banquet again, and he's gonna call for Queen Esther to come in naked and in a royal crown, and she's gonna come because she's better than Vashti. Right? Women now will know, okay, you can't, when the king calls for you naked and in a crown, just a crown, you know, you're gonna come because, see what I'm to Vashti. Right? That makes no sense. What makes sense is that the king called for his wife, called for his queen, and she said no. She just outright said no. Simple as that. Right? Bottom line is, the king wasn't having it. The princes weren't having it. The wise men weren't having it. The counselors weren't having it. I was saying, the husbands, the men, they rule, right? And we need a woman that, is going to, a queen that's going to fall in line. That's what it is. Preach that in church. And you'll have more happier marriages. That may I talk about. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Have a good day.